in this video, we are going to make the smallest home automation project, which is capable of controlling up to 4 AC appliances and also speed of 1 AC fan by just using the ESP01 as the only Wi-Fi microcontroller board. Yes, controlling all those appliances with the help of that smallest microcontroller board that just have 4 GPIO pins built in. And all this made possible using that magical shift register that we have used in this project. So this video will definitely help you to clear all your concepts about how to increase the number of output pins of any microcontroller board and how to utilize them properly by writing a stable code to make our own reliable home automation project or products. So this is not just proof of concept, but it's a combination of a stable hardware and a stable code that you can utilize for any of your automation project or products. So before moving ahead, if you are watching me for the very first time, well, consider subscribing this channel as you are definitely losing a lot of informative and educational stuff in the field of IoT, home automation and electronics. That being said, let's start with our smallest yet very useful stable home automation project using ESP01 module. Yaar, ye wala bahut awesome project hai, maza aa jayega. Let's get started. Before starting the video, let me tell you one really interesting and useful feature of our sponsor LTM, which is a PCB designer based software company, and that feature is called as design review. Using LTM, you can add any member to your project, and after that, they can highlight any fault in the schematic or can report availability of components in the inventory on the PCB to your designer so that they can visualize these components and can work upon it to provide a smooth flow of PCB production even if they both are in any corner of the world. So that's the design review feature, and even you can try out this and many other features of LTM for free by just clicking on the link mentioned in the description, as you'll be getting an access to free trial version using that link. Now let's start with our video. So coming back to our video, so now for making this project, you'll need these all components whose list you can easily find in the article whose link is attached in the description of this video. And you need to connect them all according to this schematic diagram. Now as you all know, I wanted to make the smallest home automation project, so I designed my own custom PCB for this project, and after designing it completely, I gave its order directly to JLC PCB. So whenever you need any custom PCB for your projects or products, you can definitely go for JLC PCB. The process is very straightforward. You just need to upload the Gerber file of your PCB project, select the number of PCBs. Well, you can also choose the color masking of your choice. Now here, I'll go for the green color masking as the production time of this color is very less. And after that, just place your order. Now, if you select the fastest delivery option, you may get the PCBs delivered at your doorstep within a week, but this method may charge import duties to you. And if you choose this delivery option, there are chances you may not need to pay any custom duty charges. But the negative point is it may take more than a month to deliver those PCBs at your doorstep. So go for the one which you think is more convenient to you. So after placing the order, I got those PCBs delivered at my studio, and at the first glance, we can definitely judge that the PCB quality is really top notch. So yeah, using this process, you can order your custom PCBs from JLC PCB, and JLC PCB not only provide those PCB based services, but they also provide a couple of more services like the PCB assembly service and the 3D printing service. You can get more information about all the services on their website whose link I'll be attaching down in the description of this video. So yeah, after getting those PCBs, we one by one shouldered all the components on it, and after shouldering them all, our final project looks like this. Neat and very compact. And just look at the size of that PCB project. It's really very small and it can easily fit inside my palm and still able to control 4 AC appliances and speed of 1 AC fan, like 4 speed fan controller. Sahi mein yaar, ye itna sara kuch kar sakta hai. With that small form factor. Ek like to banta hai yaar. Do click the like button if you're already loving this project. And hey, did I share that information that we are selling this complete project? Yes, we are selling it, and I'll let you know the more information about it at the end of the video. Now let us move ahead with this video and let us focus on the coding part of the project, which is also really very important. Okay, so here is the code used for our smallest home automation project based on ESP26601 model. Starting with the Blink libraries, of course, you need to have the Blink library already installed onto your Arduino IDE. And secondly, you also need to have the ESP26 port packages already installed. So these two are prerequisite, you can say. Okay, after that, here you need to provide the Blink template ID because this is the Blink version 2.0 and also the authentication token. So first of all, let us create a Blink template and device into the Blink cloud. For that, you just need to go to blink.cloud website, log into your account, and after that just click here and click on new template. I'll name this template as a smallest home automation. It's based on ESP8266. Connection type is Wi-Fi. That's it. Click on done button. After that, here go to data stream and here click on plus sign and click on virtual pin. Now here we'll be adding total 5 data stream, 4 for the appliances and 1 for the speed of the fan. Okay, so first appliance name will be relay 1. You can name it according to your choice. Click on create, and similarly I'll create 3 different relays quickly. Great, so we have successfully created 4 different data stream for 4 relay, and now I'll click on new data stream again, click on virtual pin again, and this time I'll name it as fan speed, and it will be virtual pin V4, no problem at all. And the minimum maximum range will be different, so minimum is 0 and maximum will be 4, so it's a 4 speed fan controller that we have embedded in our project, so speed will go from 0 to 4. Click on the create button, and with this we have successfully created the data streams, or we can say the virtual pins used in this particular project. Click on the save button, and here go inside this, or like click on the search icon here, click on new device, select from template, and we will choose the template that we have just created, which is smallest home automation. Click on the create button, and we have successfully created a template and device inside the new Blink account. We'll be configuring the dashboard inside the mobile application only, okay? But on the right hand corner, as you can see, we got all the details like the template ID, the device name, and the authentication token, okay? So I'll simply copy these details. I copied the template ID, I'll paste that here. After that, I'll copy the authentication token as well, and I will paste that here. Okay, that's pretty much it. Let us move ahead. So here we need to provide the SSID name and password of our Wi-Fi router because this project do works on internet. After that, we have defined the pin numbers for all the pin, like the data pin, latch pin, clock pin, as 0, 2 and 3 respectively. Now these 3 pins are the pins of the shift resistor. So if you don't know what is a shift resistor, how to use it, how it works, then I'll definitely recommend you to watch out my previous video whose link is in the I button as well as in the description, in which I have covered everything about how to use a shift register, how to cascade a shift register to increase the number of outputs more than 8, right? So everything is discussed in that particular video. Do watch that out. After that, here I created 2 different variables, Blink data and previous Blink data. We'll come to know about the importance of these 2 variables once we go through the complete code. Okay, so let's move on to the setup part first. So here in the setup part, we are just beginning the Blink, okay, pretty normal, and we are just declaring everything as an output, and then we are writing the default data to our shift register, okay. So this is the format to, you know, provide the output in the shift register. First we need to make the latch pin as low, then we have to use the shift out function to send the data serially, and then we'll be turning that latch pin high. So whenever it goes from low to high, the data will be reflected inside the output part. Okay, so these 3 lines will make sure that initially all the output pins will be at logic low, means all the relays will be turned off. Okay, now inside the loop part, we have 2 functions. One is the blink.run, that is the built-in function of the Blink library, which is responsible for running all the Blink related tasks in the background. And second is blink_run, which is created by our team, which is responsible for reflecting whatever data coming from the Blink to the shift register or to the output relay basically. Okay, so now let's just try to understand the code and let's see how the code will react whenever we receive data from the mobile application, starting with the virtual pin V0. Okay, this is for the relay 1. So what it will do is, as soon as we receive any data from virtual pin V0, this function will be called. Whatever data we have received will be stored inside the pin value variable. That is pretty common, right? After that, what we are doing is we're comparing whether the data is 1 or whether the data is 0. Now here I want to make one thing clear to you. Whenever we want to turn any bit to high, we'll be using the OR logic, and whenever we want to turn any bit to low, we'll be using the and logic. Okay, so here as we want to turn on the relay, we are using the OR logic, and here as you want to turn off the relay, we are using the AND logic. So this logic will be, you know, remaining the same for all the bits that we are using. Now second thing which I also want to make sure to you, that here we just need to change the bit zero of the whole byte. We don't want to change the data of all other bits in the bytes. Okay, so for that, what you need to do is we need to use zero for all other bits. Now why zero? Well, if you see the truth table of an OR gate, you can see that whenever any data is ORed with zero, the data remains as it is. So if it is one previously, it will remain one after ORing as well. And if the data is zero previously, the data will still remain zero after ORing with zero. That's why we have used zero for all other bits. So our task is clear. We just want to make this bit as one, which is cleared by this particular line. And what if we are receiving the data zero from the mobile application? Well, it will go inside the else part, and here we are ANDing it, because as I discussed, if you want to turn off any bit, we use the AND logic. Okay, so here I just turned off the bit at position zero, but I don't want to change all other bits in the remaining position. So for that, here we are using the digital data one. Now why one? So if you observe the truth table of AND logic carefully, then you'll observe that whatever the data may be, if we AND that data with digital one, the data remains as it is. So if the previous data is zero, the data will still remain zero, or if the previous data is one, the data will remain one. Okay, so the data won't change whenever we AND it with the digital logic one. Okay, so that's what we have did here as well. We have put all the bit at position one, so whenever we are ANDing it, the data will remain as it is. The only data will change at the position zero. Okay, so that was a bit complex logic used to turn on and off any bit in particular byte using ANDing and ORing and everything. So even if you know basics about this AND gates and OR gates and this binary numbers, the concept must be clear to you. But if you are not familiar about those particular things, well, again, rewind this video and listen to me very carefully, and you'll come to know how we made this particular logic. Okay, but this is a pretty solid logic. It will work for all the time, and it is a stable logic. Okay, so similarly, same kind of logic we have used for all other data as well. So if we are receiving any data from virtual pin V1, what we are doing is we are just in the bit at this particular position. Okay, so if we want to turn it on, we are ORing it with this particular byte. If you want to turn the data off, we are just ANDing the data with this particular byte. Okay, similarly, we are doing it for virtual pin V2 and V3. Now comes the virtual pin V4, on which we have attached a fan speed controller. So it's no more 0 and 1, rather it's a 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are in total 5 different possibilities in this particular virtual pin. Let us see how we are dealing with those 5 different cases. Okay, so here we have just used the switch case, you can see. Okay, so as soon as we receive the data, what we are doing is we are comparing it, whether the data is 0, 1, 2, 3 or 4. So these are the only possibilities. Okay, so let's assume that we have received the speed 1 from the mobile application, so this condition will be satisfied. So first of all, we are ANDing the logic with all the 3 bits as 0, so means we are, you know, clearing all the 3 bits of the fan speed control. And after that, we are ORing that with 001. Okay, 001 represent the speed 1 of the fan. Okay, so that's what we are doing here. In case we receive the speed 2, we are ANDing it with a 0 first of all. After that, we are ORing it with 010, which is for fan speed 2, then 011, which is for fan speed 3, and 100, which is for fan speed 4. Okay, so yeah, this is how we are storing all the data inside the blink underscore data variable. But one thing is remaining: how we are sending this blink underscore data variable to the actual relay. Well, for that, we need to check out this particular function, which is blink underscore run. So here what we are doing is we are again using a gate called as XOR gate. Okay, so now if you observe the truth table of XOR gate carefully, then you'll come to know that we are getting the data one whenever there is two different bit at the input side. If the two bits at the input side are same, the output will be zero. The output will be only one whenever two bits are different. So that logic we have used. So whenever the previous blink data and the current blink data is different, then and then only this condition will be satisfied. So there's a very smart logic embedded by our team in this particular code. So whenever we are getting some new data, this condition will satisfy. It will change that new data to the previous blink data variable. And after that, we are turning low the latch pane. Then we are using the shift out function to, you know, send the new data to the shift register. We are turning that latch pin high. So whenever it's go from low to high, the data will be reflected at the output side of the shift register, where the relay will be turned on and off based upon the new data received. Okay. So this was the complex, a bit complex logic, you can say, but this is a very stable logic and it works all the time flawlessly without any false triggering at all. Okay, so that was it about the code. Well, I'll really appreciate my team for writing this amazing code, and if you appreciate it as well, well, ek like kar do ya, team ko motivation milegi. So yeah, what I'll do now is I'll select the right board, which is generic ESP8266 module. Select the right COM port, which is this one. Now here I have used my universal USB to TTL programmer and made the connection between the programmer and ESP01 module according to this connection diagram. So after that, I'll straight away hit the upload button. So in the meanwhile, let me show you how to configure the mobile application of the new Blink app. So here, first of all, open the Blink mobile application. And here, as you can see, the smallest home automation project already appeared inside the main home screen. Okay, after that, I'll click on this particular project or device, you can say, click on this icon, tap on the screen, and here we can add the button. So I'll add the button here, tap on the button, and here I'll select the data stream as relay one. Okay, that's okay. One more thing, I will change the mode to switch because I want to use it as a switch. And similarly, I'll add other three buttons quickly. Okay, now for the fan speed, I'll tap on the screen and I'll add a slider here. Okay, I'll maximize this slider and I'll tap on the slider, select the data stream as fan speed, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll click on the cross icon, click on the cross icon again, and as you can see, we have successfully created a mobile dashboard for controlling our smallest home automation project. Now let's just move on to the assembly part of the project. That was the smallest home automation project, and as I said earlier, we are selling this complete project through our website, in which you'll be getting all the components already shouldered on the PCB project along with the ESP01 model, which you just need to program it with our Blink code, which we'll also be providing in our GitHub repository. And after that, just make that project connection with your home appliances, whose connection diagram you'll also get along with that project purchase. So go get one for your home and office and make your home and office a smart home and smart office with the smallest cute looking home automation project. Just purchase link is down in the description. It is available at an affordable price, so anyone can get that project. Yeah, bahut cute hai yaar. Like, if you don't want to use it as well, have it for your desk. It looks very cute, interesting and attractive as well. Okay, so that's it about the project selling. And also, if you just want those tiny relays and are struggling to find those relays online, well, we also provide those relays separately if you want. Okay, so those relays are also listed on our techiesms.com/components website, whose link is also attached in the description. And if you want to purchase anything in bulk, maybe the relay, maybe the project, maybe any other components, you can always ask for the discount through our Instagram handle or the WhatsApp number, whose details are down in the description. Okay, jab bhi kabhi yaar bulk mein kuch purchase karna hai, bindas discount mango, and we'll be shipping all those on the same day with our same day shipping policy. So yeah, that was everything from my side. I hope you liked the project. I hope you liked the concept. I hope you liked the way we presented this project to you. If is it so, do click the like button and tell YouTube algorithm and our team as well. Yeah, ye video bahut acha hai. Tum bahut sahi kaam kar rahe ho. Do click the like button. Also, do let me know in the comments about kya chahiye aur what you want to add to this particular home automation project. Kya smallest home automation mein hum inputs bhi lene ka try kare? Do you think we should add these things as well? And do let me know your suggestion, thoughts, ideas down in the comments of the video. And definitely work on those ideas, suggestions. And yeah, that being said, I am just ending this video here. And now, just wait for my next video and explore, learn, share with me, Techie SMS.